Hello, everybody, and thank you very much, and welcome to today's special online conversation and factory tour, Tango Chirimen, factory visit and conversation. Thank you so much. My name is Simon Wright, and I am the Director of Programming at Japan House London. And this is the first of our Nuno online field trips. And we're very excited to be able to hold this today for you. So for all of you watching, please note that your microphone and webcam will be disabled for the entire duration of the event, but you will be able to ask questions. Please do at any time during the session. Please type your questions for the presenters. We will have time at the end of the session to try and answer as many questions as possible. You can send it with your name or anonymously. Questions will be collected by our Japan House moderators to enable that to happen. Please note that the contents of this event will be streamed live on Facebook, YouTube, and LinkedIn, where a recording will be archived later. So for today's event, we are broadcasting live from London in the United Kingdom, and also from two locations in Japan. And shortly, I'll be handing you over to our main presenter, Tamoe Hayato, who is a manufacturer of Tango Chirimen in Kyotango, in the north of Kyoto Prefecture, and then also to Surureko, who is joining us from home in Tokyo. Tamoe Hayato-san and Sudo Reiko-san will discuss their work with Tango Chirimen, and then we will move on to a factory tour personally guided by Tamoe-san in Kyotango in Kyoto. So, our speaker Sudo Reiko is the focus of Japan House London's new exhibition, Making Nuno, Japanese Textile Innovation from Sudoreko. And this is due to open on the 17th of May, just in a few days' time from this particular recording. So please, if you are able to visit, we will welcome you. With open arms, we're very excited to be open again. And some of the textiles that are in the exhibition are part of a display which we have featuring those Tango Chirimen textiles made by different manufacturers and designed with the collaboration of Nuno. And this is one of these is called Silk Ribbon Lines from the Ito Asobi Workshop. This you can also see in Japan House London, of course. The other is Silver Leaf from Tamiya Raden. We also have Burnout Ball from Miyashin. And we also have Papillon from Taiyu. And Taiyu Kigyo, of course, is the feature of today's session. Hello, Tamoe-san. Thank you very much for joining us. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you very much indeed. And I have actually some of your textile with us, with me today, which we have on display at Japan House London. So we're delighted to see the processes behind it. Thank you very much indeed. So Tamoe-san is the managing director of Taiyu Textile Industry. And since its founding in 1931, Taiyu has been producing Tango Chirimen in the Tango region of Kyoto Prefecture. Tamoe-san took over the family business from his father in 2002 and became the third CEO. He has introduced wide textile looms to the factory that had previously specialized in Japanese style clothing. And this enabled the company to also produce fabrics sufficiently wide enough to make other styles of clothing using Tango Chirimen. Since 2019, Tamoe-san has been deputy director of the Tango Textile Industrial Association. Thank you very much, Tamoe-san, for joining us. We're very happy to have you with us. And also joining us from Tokyo is Sudo Reiko.
Konbanwa.
Hello, konnichiwa.
Hello.
you very much for joining us. For everyone who's joining us today, I'll give a brief introduction, if I may, Sudo-san. Sudo Reiko is the design director of Nuno Corporation, where she combines the Japanese craft traditions of dyeing and weaving with cutting edge technology to create a wide range of innovative textiles. She is renowned for pushing boundaries of textile production and championing new methods of sustainable manufacture. She is a member of the Japan Design Committee and she joined Muji's advisory board in 2016. Sudo-san is frequently invited to give lectures and hold exhibitions around the world. For example, Koinobori Now, a major art installation at the National Art Center in Tokyo in 2018, actually became the catalyst for what you finally see in Japan House London via a beautiful exhibition in Hong Kong at the end of 2019. Thank you so much, Sudo-san, for joining us. Thank you. We are going to start the session with a presentation and conversation between Tamoe-san and Sudo-san. And to help this, we also are joined by Bethan Jones, who will be interpreting for us all. Thank you so much, Bethan, for joining. So if I may now hand over to Tamoe-san and to Sudo-san, we look forward to hearing what you will tell us, and then we will have a factory tour afterwards. Thank you so much.
Hi. Hi.
Good evening from Tokyo to all of you participating in Tokyo's first online, today's first online field trip. So we will be visiting a textile workshop in Kyotango region that faces onto the Japan Sea north of Kyoto. From Tokyo, we take the Shinkansen bullet train, then change to a regional express, and finally board a two-carriage local, some 6.5 hours travel time in all. There, we will meet a very good friend of mine, Tamoe-san, who is the technician president of a silk weaving company. I'm really looking forward to this. Tamoe-san, yes.
それでは改めましてよろしくお願いいたします。私はタユキヨ株式会社のタモイハヤトと申します。
Hello everyone, it's lovely to be here. My name is Tamoe Hayato and I'm the Managing Director of Taiyu Textile Industry Company.
弊社は京都府の北部に位置しておりまして、丹後半島にあります。我が町京丹後市には日本海側に面しています。弊社はそこで主に着物に使用される丹後ちりめんを製造している機屋となります。絹織物の糸作りから織物まで一貫して行っております。
We are located on the Tango Peninsula in the north of Kyoto Prefecture, and the town overlooks the Japan Sea. We're weavers. We produce a silk fabric called Tango Chirimen, which is mainly used for kimono. And we carry out the entire process from spinning the yarn through to weaving the fabric.
Tango は絹織物の産地としての歴史は古く、1300年以上前から織られています。丹後でちりめんが織られて昨年で300年。
The silk weaving tradition in Tango goes back at least 1300 years, and we've been making ちりめん here for 300 years last year.
この写真は300年前に絹屋平治さんが初めて丹後で織ったちりめんが現存しています。
This photo shows the very first ちりめん that was weaved here in Tango 300 years ago.
私は3代目で、祖父の代から友禅染めなどに使用される白生地を作り続けています。
I'm the third generation of my family. My grandfather started weaving silk fabric for 友禅 dyeing that's done in Kyoto and Kanazawa.
それでは丹後産地でできる絹織物の特徴から説明させていただきます。
I'd like to start by saying a few words about the characteristics of our Tango silk.
この写真は、みこしちりめんと呼ばれる生地となります。生地と撚りの様子を拡大した写真になります。
So this slide shows you a zoomed in photograph of a fabric called mikoshi chirimen, along with the individual threads.
このみこしちりめんは縦糸にはよりの入らない生糸を使用します。横糸には強年子と弱年子を交互に織る織物となります。
The warp threads are non-twisted yarns, and the weft threads are a combination of Z and S spun, overspun wefts and twisted yarns.
この写真は弊社で生殖しているチリメンの種類の一例となります。この左の写真はいわゆるチリメンとなります。平織りで脂肪のある生地です。
These are some examples of the silks that we weave here. On the left, we have a flat woven chirimen silk crepe. You can see the distinctive crimped texture.
右の写真は、紋織りチリメンで柄の入った生地となります。
And on the right, we have a patterned 紋織りチリメン。
タモイさん、how many workshops in Tango are currently involved in making silk?
今、単語織物工業組合に属している畑屋さんの件数で約650件弱です。
There are about 650 weavers currently members of the Tango Textile Industrial Association.
How about the pattern?
はい。紋織りの紋様は正直数えきれないぐらいあります。
Wow.
There are countless patterns to these patterned chirimen crepes.
それではまずはチリメンの生存技術の中でも最も特徴的な技術である水織りの八丁年子の工程となります。
Let's take a look first then at one of the most distinctive processes that go into making this chirimen, and that's the 八丁練り wet twisting technique.
Tamoi-san, is there something about the local climate in Tango that lends itself to making silk textiles?
はい。この Tango 地方はすごく雨が多くて多湿の気候となります。それが絹織物には適したと思います。
There's a lot of rain. It's a very humid region, and that is really suited to silk weaving.
水はすごくちりめんを作るのに大切な重要な要素となっていきます。
Water is incredibly important for silk weaving.
So that case, like, do you use well water for storing and twisting yarns?
そうですね。水質が井戸の水はあまりよろしくないので、山の方から伏流水を引っ張ってきて、それを水道を使っています。
The quality of well water isn't that great for twisting. So we actually bring water down from the mountains via a water channel that we've built.
That's interesting.
それでは続けます。この釜で約30分熱湯で炊き込みます。
So we start by boiling the thread or steaming the thread for about 30 minutes.
生糸はセリシンという二皮質で表面を覆われています。
The surface of the raw silk thread is covered with a gluey substance called sericin.
まずは熱湯で糸を炊き、糸全体を柔らかくすることで、1メーターの間に3000回を超えるような強い撚りが容易に入れることができます。
So first of all, this has to be removed and the thread softened so that we can twist it up to 3,000 times.
柔らかくなった糸をこのように管に巻きます。
Once the thread is softened, we wind it onto these reels.
糸が巻かれた管を粘式にかけて寄っていきます。
And the reels are loaded onto the machine to be twisted.
これが寄っている様子になります。
And that's what's happening here.
このように糸が乾かないように水を落としながら寄っていきます。乾いてしまうと、よりが入らなくなり、生殖したときに脂肪のムラになってしまいます。
The reels have to be kept wet during the twisting process, so water is constantly dripped onto them. If the thread dries out, it won't twist, and then you won't get that even crimp effect on the finished fabric.
これは陶器でできたおもしで、シズワと言います。
These are ceramic weights called shizuwa.
So, Tamoji-san, that heavier the ceramic weight, the more than a number of twists?
はい。このおもしは糸の太さによって変えていきます。細いと軽くしますし、太くなると重くしていきます。
We actually choose the weight to use based on the thickness of the thread. So the thinner the thread, the lighter the weight. The thicker the thread, the heavier the weight.
So will there be a problem making these weight in the future? Are you thinking about using other materials?
はい。先生の言われる通り、もう現在では作っていません。弊社ではこれだけたくさんのシズワを保管しています。これはうちの財産になります。
As you say, these aren't made anymore. So we have this huge stock of them, and this is our, one of our really valuable assets.
これも酔っている様子になります。
Another photo here of the twisting process.
より上がった糸をこちらのシリンダーで巻き取っていく様子です。
And then the twisted yarn is reeled onto these spools.
この巻き取りスピードを速くすると、よりの回数は少なくなり、ゆっくり巻き取っていくと、多くのより数が入れることになります。
The faster the thread is spooled, the fewer twists you end up with. The slower it's spooled, the more twists you end up with.
揺れ上がった糸は弊社では1週間かけて完全に乾燥させます。
Once the yarn is twisted, it takes about a week to dry completely.
乾燥させることで、セリシンがもう一度固まり、よりが戻らないように、より止めの効果が得られます。
And once the thread is dried, the sericin rehardens, which stops the thread from becoming untwisted.
セリシンがついている生地なのでできる綿糸であって、今となっては日本の和装独特の技術だと思います。
This whole process is only possible because of that sericin that exists on the silk. I think it's a unique process to the Japanese kimono industry.
ここからは縦糸の工程で成形って言います。
The next stage of the process is called warping.
弊社ではこのように砂の上に糸を立てます。砂の
We stand the spools on sand.
砂の上に糸を立てる理由は、歯間が砂にめり込むことで隙間がなくなり、成形器を止めた時などに糸が引っかからないようにするためであります。
The reason we use sand is because the spools sink into the sand, and when the machine stops, there's no risk of the thread getting caught underneath the spool.
生殖する織物に必要な本数の縦糸をこちらの木枠に巻き取っていきます。
So we wind the number of warps that we need to create the textile onto this drum.
Tamoji-san, how many kimonos will one set of warps weave?
はい、弊社ではだいたい10着分ぐらいの糸を巻きます。だいたいまあ20着分ぐらいとかですかね。
ってことはだいたい it will be about
We usually wind enough warps for 10 or so kimono, sometimes up to 20.
Yes.
So that means
But because we do every stage of the process ourselves, there may be cases when we need to warp the threads for just a single kimono.
成形するときは用意した糸を砂の上に均等に並べ、隣り合わせの糸が絡まないようにまっすぐ糸を引き上げていきます。
The spools are spaced out evenly on the sand, and the threads have to go straight up so that they don't get tangled with one another.
一度に織物に必要な本数が巻けませんので、120本や160本の一つの組にして巻き取る部分成形を行います。
We can't actually warp enough threads for a kimono in one go. So we take 120 to 160 at a time.
ちりめんを生殖する場合の縦糸は 26デニールの木糸が約1万本必要となってきます。
To weave Truman, you actually need about 10,000 26 denier threads.
これも成形している様子になります。
That's another photograph of the warping process.
このようにドラムに巻き取っていきます。
Those warp threads are wound around the drum.
ドラムを横から見た様子になります。
Here it is from the side.
ここからが生殖になります。
And now we move on to weaving.
40年前のジャガード織機になります。
This is a 40-year-old Jaggard loom.
この手前にある紙が紋紙で、柄を織るための情報となっています。
And these are the punch cards that determine the pattern that will be woven.
先ほど説明したジャガード織機でパピリオンを生殖している様子です。
And this shows you the papillon textile being woven on a jacquard loom.
こちらが布様と共同で作り、現在ジャパンハウスのギャラリーでも展示している織物となります。
This is the fabric that we've developed alongside Nuno and that you can currently see in the exhibition at Japan House.
横糸にこの浮いている糸がありますが、部分的に織り込んでいく縫い取りという方法で織っています。
You can see these white horizontal lines. These are floating wefts. They are extra overspun wefts.
パピリオは生地のベースを組織させる横糸を先に糸を染めて使用していきます。
The papillon textile uses these pre-dyed red weft threads.
それとこちらの横糸は縫い取り部分に使う21デニールを14本合わせ8丁年糸で1メートルの間に2300回ぐらいのよりを入れた強年糸となります。
And then for those supplementary overspun wefts, the floating ones, it uses these threads on the right, which are 14 lots of 21 denier yarns that are twisted together using the wet twisting hachō nenshi technique, 2,300 twists per meter.
シャトルに横糸を入れます。
The weft is loaded onto the shuttle.
この下に、赤に染めた駒糸を入れています。
And then the red weft is on this lower shuttle.
上には、縫い取りの部分の強捻糸を入れています。
The overspun white weft thread is on the upper shuttle.
このようにシャトルが縦糸の間を通り織物になっていきます。
And the shuttle passes between the warp threads to weave the textile.
縦糸はよりの入らない黄糸と強捻糸を組み合わせたストライプ状の模様にしています。
The warp threads consist of a mixture of plain untwisted thread and overspun thread to create this pattern.
この白い部分の糸が強捻糸になります。このように縫い取りで折った部分をすべて手でカットしていきます。
The white threads here are those overspun floating wefts, and they are all cut by hand.
この作業がこの織物で一番大変な作業かもわかりません。
Which is possibly the hardest part of creating this fabric.
ごめんなさい。
Sorry, I shouldn't laugh.
ここからは精錬の工程になります。
Next, we have the refining or scouring process.
精錬とは、絹のついている精神や不純物を取り除く作業になります。
Here we wash off the sericin as well as any impurities.
Tamoi san, all six textiles woven in Tango are taken for quality control inspection by the cooperative in order to maintain your high standards.
生地を仕上げるのに、この精錬は非常に大切な工程になります。生地の折れですとか、生地同士がぶつかり合って擦れなどに注意をして精錬していきます。
This process is a really important one for creating the Truman fabric. You have to be very careful of folding the fabric or chafing it.
When this, did this system start?
はい。今年で組合が設立されてちょうど100年になります。はい。
The Industrial Association is actually celebrating its 100th anniversary this year.
So what special concern do you have when asked to finish fabric?
そうですね。先ほど言いましたように、折り、生地の折れだとか、すれに注意したり、やっぱ生地の扱いには気をつけてやってます。
You have to be really careful when handling this fabric. As I mentioned, you don't want to be folding it or being too abrasive and chafing it.
Thank you. 大体の絹織物は糸の段階で精錬染色する織物が多いですが、ちりめんの場合は繊維のついた生糸を織り込んで染色した後に精錬をすることで脂肪や絹本来の光沢また風合いを出す織物となります。
Normally with silk fabrics, this refining and scouring process is done to the thread before it's woven. But with chilimen, you weave the threads that still have the sericin on them and then wash the sericin off afterwards, which is what gives you the distinctive crimped texture of the fabric and the beautiful luster of this type of silk.
粗練り、本練り、漂白、仕上げ練りと釜を変えながら約8時間かけて精錬していきます。
The whole process takes about 8 hours. The fabric is moved from bath to bath and it goes through a series of processes from a rough scouring to the main scouring to bleaching and then a final scouring.
これがパピリオを精錬している様子になります。
And this shows us doing that to the papillon fabric.
この右の写真のようにこのネットの釜につけていきます。
Here it is being lowered into the bath of hot water.
縫い取りの部分の強粘紙のよりが戻り、このような形状の生地となります。
The white floating overspun yarns untwist themselves during the scouring process, and this is the result.
この部分はカットし忘れてまして、練り上がった後にもう一度カットして、それからまた精錬に出します。
This white stripe here is a bit that we've missed when we were cutting the threads. So this will now have to be cut and re-scoured.
Again.
これは乾燥、また幅出ししている工程なんです。
Yep, and here it is being dried.
こちらは生地を一旦一旦検査しているところになります。
And then every single piece of fabric has to be inspected.
パピリオを折らさせていただいて思ったのは、強粘紙を縫い取りで折り、その部分をカットして精錬することで生まれる生地の表情がとても可愛らしく、強粘紙の使い方が非常に面白い織物だと思いました。
Going through the process of creating and producing this fabric made me think that this is a really interesting way of using the overspun yarn. Floating the overspun wefts and then cutting them so that you and scouring so that you end up with this finish. And I find it really, really adorable.
Thank you. ありがとうございます。
こちらこそ。
Thank you.
この写真は弊社の工場の敷地内にある庭となります。
This is the garden of our factory.
東福寺などの庭を策定された日本の策定家で研究家の重森美玲先生が手掛けた庭を紹介いたします。
It's a garden designed by Shigemori Mire, who designed the garden of 東福寺 Temple.
Goodness. You have a garden by Shigemori-san. That's amazing. Goodness me. I'd quite like one of those if I could. Wow. That's incredible. Thank you very much for showing us your garden too. Oh, wonderful. Thank you so much. Thank you for the presentation and to Sudo-san as well. Thank you so much for joining there.And Tamoi-san, I know is now going to prepare to give us a factory tour. And Sudo-san, you will join us, won't you, later for the question and answer session as well. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.
それでは工場見学の方に行きましょう。
Thank you. Thank you.
Let's go on a tour.
So Tamoi-san is changing camera and he will show us various areas of the factory, looking at the processes of Hachou, Nenshi, Seike, and Hataba. And I have here, of course, I'll just show you a little bit more. We have the fabric that Tamoi-san was showing us, which we do have in Japan House. And you can, if you have the opportunity to visit the exhibition in person and our shop as well, you can enjoy a retail experience with the Tango Chinimen limited edition by Nuno yourself. And it is really very, very beautiful to feel and to touch. So thank you very much. I will hand over now, if I may, to Tamoi-san.
こちらがうちの年始の工場になります。水寄りの工場になります。
This is the workshop that we use for the wet twisting.
今で4台から5台ぐらいの今年式が動いてます。
There are 4 or 5 twisting machines in operation at the moment.
ここがその300年前に丹後に伝わってきた技術の水寄りの八丁年始になります。
This uses that technique that was, that was passed on to us in Tango 300 years ago.
まずあの奥の釜でのね、奥の釜で熱湯で糸を焚きます。
So the threads are first boiled in the hot water over there.
柔らかくなった糸をこのように管に巻きます。
The soft threads are brought over here and wove and wound onto these reels.
で、これが今燃焼しているところになります。
And this is where the twisting happens.
このスピンドルが約6000回ぐらいのスピードで回っています。
The spindles are revolving at about a rate of about 6,000.
それでずっと糸が出てきて、この沈むまで糸にテンションをかけながら寄っていく。
And the weights that we saw before are down here, tensioning the thread as it twists.
この今寄っている糸は、26デニールの糸が7本合わさって、だいたい3000回の寄りを入れています。
The thread that's being twisted right now, is made up of7 26 denier threads, and it's being twisted at about 3,000 twists per meter.
こちらで左寄りを寄って、向こうで右寄りを今同時に寄っています。
On this side we're doing left-hand twists, and on the far side we're doing right-hand twists.
先ほど説明したこの奥にあるのが沈場の、保管された沈場です。
And here are those weights that we saw in the presentation, our stock of Shizuwa weights.
それで今度は寄り上がりましたら、乾燥室に入れて糸を乾燥させます。
Once the yarns are twisted, they're brought over here to dry.
こちらが乾燥室になります。
This is the drying room.
このように乾燥室に入れて糸を1週間ぐらいかけて完全に乾燥させます。
Takes about a week to dry completely.
そうしますとセリシンが固まり、よりが戻らないようによより止めの効果があります。
And when it's dry, the sericin will harden, and that will stop the thread from untwisting.
これを今お湯につけてやりますとセリシンが溶け出すとこれが糸が散りつきます。
If you put this in hot water, the sericin will soften again, and the thread will crinkle up because the twist will untwist.
その戻る力によって生地の表面の細かな凹凸の脂肪が作られるわけです。
And that's what gives you the fine crinkle pattern on the surface of the churimen fabric.
はい。それでは次の工程に行きます。
Let's move on to the next process.
この乾燥までがこの水よりの八丁捻糸の工程となります。
The wet twisting process finishes here with the drying.
次の工程は、
この水より
で寄った糸をまた複数本合わせて、今度は乾いた状態で捻糸をしていきます。
Is to twist those dried threads again. Twist a number of them together in a dry state.
先ほど水が大事だっていうお話をしましたが、もうちょっと暗くなって見えないですけど、向こうに2キロほど先に山があります。
I mentioned the importance of water to weaving before, and it's hard to see right now because it's dark. But about 2 kilometers in that direction, there's a mountain.
そこの山から伏流水を引っ張ってきて、祖父の代の戦後間もなしに水道組合を旗屋が集まって作りました。
And just after the war, my grandfather's generation set up a cooperative to build this waterway, bringing water down from the mountain to be used in the weaving.
今アップにしたのがその大正水道っていう、これが水の仕切り弁になります。
And that's what you've just seen there.
ここからが成形、また旗を折るところの工場になっていきます。
This is the workshop where we do the warping and the weaving.
ここが縦糸を巻く工程の成形になります。
Here's where we do the warping of the warp threads.
先ほど説明しましたように、このように砂の上に糸を立てます。
And here they are, sitting on the sand, as I showed you previously.
これで160本の糸が立ってます。
We've got 160 warp yarns here.
で、このドラムにずっと糸を巻き取っていくわけですね。
And they will be wound onto this drum.
で、織物に必要な本数分をすべてこのドラムに巻き取っていきます。
We'll wind on as many warp threads as we need for the fabric.
で、こちら側でこのビームという芯棒にこう巻き返していきます。
And then they will be re-wound onto this beam.
この本数が、これは紋織の縦糸なので、3760本という糸数があります。
This one here is for Mongori patterned churimen. So there are 3,760 warp threads for that type of fabric.
ここからがうちの旗番になります。
And here is the weaving workshop.
全部でこちらの工場とこちらの工場で60台の織機があります。
We have 60 looms in total in these two areas.
着物を織る織機ですので、着物用の幅の狭い生地を織る専用の織機となります。
These are for weaving kimono, so they're narrow, special looms for kimono width.
だいたい40センチぐらいの幅の生地を織っています。
They weave fabric that's about 40 centimeters wide as a rule.
これがジャガード織機になります。
This one here is a jacquard loom.
これが紋紙ですね。
And here are the punch cards.
はい。この紋紙によってこのような柄が織りこなせるということになるわけです。
These punch cards will give you a pattern like this.
それではこれから1台だけ織機を動かします。
I'm going to switch one of these looms on just for you to have a look.
この織機はちりめん織る技術を応用して着物用ではなくて洋装用の幅広い生地を織る織機となります。
This loom here uses the ちりめん weaving technique to weave wider fabric that's suitable for Western style clothing.
一台動かしただけでも結構うるさい音が鳴りますけれども、平日ですと全部で40台弱の織機が動きます。どのような工場か想像していただくと、いいかもわかんないですね。
When I switch this on, you'll see that even one loom is quite noisy. So just imagine when 40 of these are operating at once on a weekday.
じゃあ動かします。
Here we go.Let's come around the front.
このように折っていきます。
And that's how the fabric is woven.
だいたいこの広幅で1メーター折るのに、約40分ぐらいでしょうかね。
It takes about 40 minutes to weave a meter of textile at that width.
着物用の生地ですと、1着分が13メーターっていう長さを折っていかないといけません。
For kimono fabric, you need 13 meters for one kimono.
だいたいこのジャガードで折っていくのに、1日に1旦折れるか折れないかになります。
And if you're using this jacquard loom to weave that fabric, you might get through one kimono in a day.
この縦糸の本数がこれはジャガードですので3760本あるということですね。
And on this jacquard loom, we have 3760 warp yarns.
うちの場合一人の織り手さんで、だいたい5台から6台の織機を動かしています。
Normally, one weaver will be in charge of 5 or 6 looms.
で、この織り上がった生地は、これから検査を社内でしまして、各工場、先ほどの精錬の工場に出荷します。
Then we inspect the fabric here in-house and send it off to be finished, to be refined.
で、精錬し終わったやつがまた会社に帰ってきまして、そこで検査をして得意先に出荷という業務になっていきます。
Then when it's been refined and scoured, it'll come back, we'll inspect it again and send it off to wherever it needs to go.
簡単でしたですけれども、今の一連の工程で、うちは単語ちりめんを製造しています。
That was a very quick tour of the whole process of making 単語ちりめん。
My goodness me, thank you so much, Tamoe-san. That was absolutely superb. Thank you so much. We are so lucky to have.You give us such a personal tour of the factory. Absolutely incredible. Thank you so much. I'm sure everybody who's watching is highly excited by this. It's amazing. Thank you very much. 本当にありがとうございます。素晴らしいことですよね。Thank you.
Wonderful.
Yes, it was. Thank you so much. Thank you, Sudo-san, for joining us again. Thank you. So we have lots of questions from people already.Coming through. So if you're able to, I'll start firing away some questions to you. First of all, we have a question. I'll do two together here. When did silk manufacture start in the Tango region? And is it known why it started? And also with that question, the machines, the looms that you've shown us today were probably, we think, introduced in the 19th century, yes, in the Meiji Restoration. How was the Chirimen made before then? What was used?
はい、まず最初の質問ですが、丹後は、日本海に面してまして、中国だとかの大陸の文化が流れ着いたと考えられています。この狭い丹後半島の中に、まあ、古墳ですねが、5000基ほどありまして、その中からも生糸を、糸にしてたと思われるような土器っていう石の道具が出土しています。
Well, the Tango region is on the Japan Sea coast, and it's a place where it's believed that culture and traditions from China and from the continent used to come over to Japan. It's a very small peninsula, but there are about 5,000 ancient burial mounds here, and they've found tools in those mounds that are believed to have been part of the silk weaving process.
で1300年前にはっきりと今でも現存している織物が正倉院に残っています。なので1300年以上前から絹織物は丹後で織られたということがはっきりしているということですね。
And there are in treasuries fabric woven silk fabric from 1300 years ago、so we know that silk was being woven here in Tango that long ago.
今のチリメンの工程だとか八丁年始だとかは今から300年前に丹後に伝わってきた技術になるわけです。
The techniques that we use for weaving chirimen and for twisting the thread came to Tango 300 years ago.
多分江戸時代の頃からでも結構柄の入った織物を織られてますので、その頃は多分当然手旗でしょうし、上で縦糸をこう上げる人がいて下で横糸を渡すとかというような織り方をしてたと想像します。
And they would have had patterned silk fabric in the Edo period before the Meiji Restoration. And so I believe back then it would have been woven by hand. You would have had someone lifting up the warp threads and someone passing through the weft threads.
明治時代には、今のリヨンですね。リヨンからジャガートっていう機械が導入され、西陣に京都の西陣に導入され、それが丹後にも伝わってきているということになっています。そうです、フランスのリヨンですね。
And then these machines, these Jacquard looms, were imported from Lyon in France to Kyoto, and then they made their way to Tango.
Marvelous. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you. We have some examples as well in the exhibition of punch cards and jacquard, an installation looking at jacquard looms as well. So if anybody who comes will have an opportunity there to look. Thank you. Thank you very much, Tamoe-san. We have some questions, a couple of questions about the twisting, actually, if I may. So one question is,What an amazing process. Thank you so much. How do you warp the loom with both high twist and untwisted silk? Is it in a particular order for the pattern?
はい。縦糸はその立てるのはルールがあって、それに沿って立てます。
Yeah, there's a pattern, there's a rule as to how you warp those different types of threads, yes.
特に今回の布様のパピリオは、強年子が4本で、よりの入らない生糸が8本、それの交互になって島の、ストライプを作っています。
For the papillon fabric, you take four overspun warps, and then eight non-twisted warps, and then repeat that to create the striped pattern.
あの狂念糸はやっぱ縮つきますので、それが本当にあの糸同士がこうひっつかないように気をつけないといけないですし、スチームを焚いて蒸気を出して、その静電気が起こらないようにしたりもします。
You do have to be careful with the overspun threads because because of the twist. And you sometimes use steam to
あの静電気が起きないように。
To suppress any static electricity.
Thank you very much. Another one which is related to twisting as well is why are Shizuwa weights no longer made? Is there a special technique or in order to make them?
まあ、残念ながらその使う工場がすごく減ったっていうことで。もうその新しい道具っていうのが作られてないんですね。それはシズワに限らず、割といろいろな工程で、あのそういう問題は起きてますね。
It's because there are fewer and fewer factories that use them. And it's not just the weights. All sorts of tools that we use are going out of production.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much.And we have a couple of questions as well about sericin, if I may as well. So I need to ask, I think, about sericin. If you could maybe explain, what is sericin and is it natural or is it a manufactured product?
あの天然のものです。絹についている成分になります。もともと絹の、あの、繊維質がこう2本ありまして、その周りにセリシンっていう二皮質。糊状のものがついているわけですね。セリシンがあるので糸同士がひっついてあの眉の形になるわけなんですね。
It's naturally occurring. It occurs on silk. It holds the strands together. It's a type of glue.
Okay.
はい。セリシンはすごくちりめんを作るのには大事な成分になります。先ほど見ていただいた八丁年始ですね。水よりのところで。セリシンがあるおかげでできる年始ということになるわけですね。
But it's really important to the process of making chirimen. The whole process only works because of that sericin.
またセリシンはあの動物性のタンパク質、まあ、絹全体はそうですけど、タンパク質なので、今ではあのすごく人間の肌にいいんですね。入浴剤に使われたりとか、こうお化粧品だとかですね、そういうものにもセリシンは使われています。はい。
It's an animal protein. Well, the whole silk itself is an animal protein, but it's really good for your skin. And so it's also used in cosmetics and bathroom products.
So, セリシンには保湿効果があったり、UV 効果があるっていうことで、結局眉はサナギの一番弱い時を守ってるので、すごくその絹自体はその中をのものを守って。
It's moisturizing, it blocks UV light. Because if you think about it, the cocoon, the silk cocoon, its job is to protect the silkworm when it's at its most vulnerable. And so it's a really a protective environment.
Okay, thank you very much indeed. Sudo-san.There are so many questions for Tamoe-san, as you must imagine, but I've got a question for you. And it's if we could hear what you're saying.
Yes, please just keep asking Tamoe-san. It's really important.
But I do have a question for you, actually, which I think is which is also for Tamoe-san a bit as well. But what drew you to Tango Chirimen, Sudo-san, as an opportunity to develop with Nuno? And it's wonderful to see the resilience and the popularity of Chirimen in contemporary times. Are there any challenges do you think, which are faced by the textile craft industry as a whole, in your opinion, Sudo-san?
Should I answer?
Sudo-san. Sudo-san, お願いします。
まず、去年市に魅了されたっていうのは、実は、私たちの布っていうのは、桐生からスタートしてるんですけれど。
The appeal of overspun yarn for me as well. Nuno itself started out in Kiryu.
桐生っていうのは、第二の京都と言われているところで、京都からちょっと遅れて着物のテキスタイルを作り出したんですよね。
Kiryu is known as the second Kyoto. They started making kimono fabric slightly later than Kyoto.
で、よりの強い糸を使って織るっていうのは、生地そのものもすごくこう厚みが出るっていうか、立体的になるんですね。細かいひだが。で、着物っていうのはこう腰の部分に人間の体重全部かかる、膝のところに全部かかる、やっぱりある程度のもうかなり強い織物ではないなければならないということがあって、それには糸作りが一番重要なんですよね。
And overspun yarns are used to make quite thick, strong structural textiles, which is what you need for a kimono, which holds really the whole weight of the body at the hip. And so they're really suited for that type of textile.
実は私たち布がスタートした時に作って、今もそうですけれども、シルクではなくて綿によりを入れる、ウールによりを入れる、よりを入れるっていうのはすごく手間がかかるので、どうしてもこう高価になってしまうんですね。
And when we started out, and now as well, we twisted not silk, but wool and cotton. And it was a really laborious process. And so it tended to be quite an expensive fabric.
すごく面白い効果が出たのは、結局安い線、シルクに比べたら、シルクが例えばキロ3万円ぐらいするとしたら、コットンは2000円とか10分の1ぐらいなんですけども、そういう糸によりをかけるなんてバカなことをする人はいなかったわけですね。
But at that time, no one else was twisting cotton threads. It seemed like a crazy thing to do, but we did it because it was 1/10 of the price of silk.
で、世の中にないそのよりをかけたコットンで織物を織る、伸びるし立体的になるし、色は濃度がこう濃く見えてくるっていう、いろんなこう効果が出てきて、これは何ですか、網ですか、なんで伸びるんですかみたいなことになって、それがまあ布のスタンダードの織物になったっていう経緯があります。
But we went about trying to twist cotton, and we got these results that it was stretchy, it was structural, you had a great depth of color in the fabric, and people wanted to know what this textile was, how we'd created it, was it knitted? And so now that is our standard textile type.
で、私たち桐生とか、関東の人間にしてみると、京都で物を作るっていうのはもう夢の夢の夢だったんですね。
And as someone from the Kanto region, the Tokyo region, making a textile in Kyoto was a kind of a dream for me.
私はその最初にやったのが2000年ですね。
And I did that for the first time in 2000.
もう本当に緊張しましたけど、京丹後で、生分解性のプラスチックを織ったんです。
I was really nervous to do it, but the first thing that we wove in Kyotango was a biodegradable plastic.
で、2016 6年でしたっけね、タモリさんとかに初めて伺った、
ね、
はい。
And then in 2016, I worked with Tamoi-san for the first time.
Wonderful. Thank you. We've had a little potted history there of how Nuno has become involved with the Tango Chirimen process, which is extremely interesting. And we can see that it's a very new process as well for Nuno in this particular case. We have actually for Japan House London for the exhibition, we have created with Nuno a film as well about the production of the textiles in Kyoto Tango, especially for this as well. So that's a brand new thing. Thank you, Sudo-san. We're about to finish, I'm afraid, but I have a couple of questions left that I would like to ask. One is to Tamoi-san. Are there many young people interested in learning and carrying out the process and learning the process of Tango Chirimen in the area?
そうですね、弊社にも20代の社員さんが2人います。30代もいます。でまた今タンゴは結構ものづくりを好きな方々で、Iターンでタンゴに来られている方が何人か増えてきてます。
We have a couple of people working for us in their 20s. We also have people in their 30s. And there are people who are coming from the city out to Tango because they want to be involved and they love the craft.
That's good to know and refreshing. And whenever I've been to a factory of some kind in Japan as well, you do see...young people working as well, and it's very important. Thank you so much. I'm very very glad. It's wonderful. Thank you so much for showing us your factory. We have one little question for you, Sudo-san, maybe, which is, we have it from Thomas. He's asking, is it possible to do an internship at Nuno?
We don't have any intensive facility, but only few days or, and somebody have to speak Japanese, I'm sorry.
That's okay. So maybe Thomas, if you're listening, thank you so much. And if you do speak Japanese, then maybe it's a possibility. please start if you would like to go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Tamoi-san, thank you. And Sudo-san, that is all we have time for today. I could stay and look at your factory and visit with you again so much more. So thank you very much, Tamoi-san. Thank you very much to everybody who helped you as well. I can see that you've created something very special for us. Thank you so much, Tamoi-san. And thank you, Sudo-san.
Thank you very much. We got so many questions, and I really hope Tamoi-san can answer the entire questions for all of them.
Lorraine, for example, has said, thank you so much for this wonderful presentation. It's a privilege to listen to you, Hayato-sensei and Sudo-sensei. That's exactly how it was written. So thank you so much. Before you disappear, I would like to show just what we've got coming up at Japan House London, if I may. We have the gallery is will be open from Monday, the 17th of May. And we have Making Nuno, Japanese Textile Innovation from Sudo Reiko. And also on our ground floor, we have the Tango Chirimen as well, including some of Tamoi-san's fabrics were made with Nuno. We also have to accompany the exhibition, Kyoto Design Lab series, Exploring Tango Chirimen, and a series of events which look at the various ways that Tango Chirimen can be utilized in the present day. That's with Kyoto Design Lab series, which is, I'm very much looking forward to that. We also have Ibiso, Textile Sustainability in Yamagata. We have, it's the second of our field trips with Sudo-san, this time to Yamagata and to the silk production there in Tsuruoka. That's on Friday the 4th of June. And we also have our virtual exhibition online for you to be able to look. Architecture for Dogs, please do have a look on that at that when you have an opportunity. Thank you so much, everybody, for having joined us. And really, really thank you very much, Mr. Tamoi, for your wonderful presentation of your factory. It's been a great privilege to have you with us today, and thank you so much. And you look wonderful in your kimono as well. Thank you so much for wearing it today, Tawaris. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Sudo-san. And we look forward to seeing everybody again. Wonderful. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Yes, thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Take care. Thank you.